Hey Blender users, it's Mike. I'm going to be showing you guys how to cut holes inside or into another object. Okay? So we've got our default cube here. I'm just gonna go front view mode and the ortho perspective, okay? And I'm going to go ahead and create another object. And let's just do a cylinder for this first one, alright? So I'm gonna rotate on the x-axis 90 degrees so it's facing us. And wireframe mode, I'm going to scale it down a bit, alright? I'm going to go to the side view mode, I'm going to scale it on the y-axis so it's sticking out of your object here about like that, okay? Doesn't matter how far, as long as it is sticking out, okay? Now what we're going to do is we're going to select our cube, go to this modifier tab, and we're going to add a modifier. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to select Boolean modifier. And instead of intersect, we want to select difference, okay? And that is just going to allow us to cut the difference out of our shape. And now we want to cut out the shape of the cylinder, so let's just select cylinder, because that's a shape. And let's apply it. Now if we move our cube over, there you go, you got a nice hole cut in the middle of your cube. And it automatically creates the vertices and everything for you. Okay? So we don't need this anymore because we applied the modifier, so we don't need it. So now you got that. Now let's say you wanted to create a just a dent in it. Okay. So let's shift A and let's add just a sphere. I'm gonna scale this down also about like that. I'm gonna drag it out a little bit. And up a little bit. And instead of having it all the way through to where it makes a hole, this time I'm just gonna leave it sticking in there. About like that. So it's halfway in, halfway out. Now let's just cut that shape out of this. Add a modifier, Boolean, difference, and select our shape that we want to be cut out. Apply. And we can delete that because we applied it. Now we have a nice little dent in our cube. Okay? Now I'm going to show you guys how to cut out a custom shape, I guess you could say. So I'm going to delete this default cube and I'm going to create a new cube. Okay? Just like that. Now I'm going to go wireframe mode, and what I'm going to do is the easiest way to make your own shape that I feel is to use curves. So I'm going to shift A and create a Bezier curve. Okay, I'm rotating the x-axis at 90 degrees so I can see what I'm doing. And click this, I'm going to scale it down. Select this handle, scale it down. Okay. So let's say I want this way up here, in that corner. I want this one down here. And it's extruded a whole bunch of times. However you want it. Now with curves, you can grab the end handles and you can move them around like that. And if you select this one, you can actually further define that curve. Okay. And let's just go like that. And now see, we have this open shape. We don't want that. We want a closed shape. And so we're going to hit Alt-C to toggle cyclic mode on. Alright? Now, we're going to go to object mode, and we have it here. Okay. But you can't cut this shape out of this object because it's not solid. So we're going to go to object mode, we're going to hit Alt-C in object mode, and we're going to convert it to mesh from a curve. Okay. So now when we look in there, you've got vertices rather than the curve handles. Okay. So select all, I'm going to go to top view mode, and I'm going to just drag it outside of our object. And what I'm going to do, since it needs to be solid, I'm going to hit Alt-F to fill it. So now we've got just a plane, basically, of that shape that we created, okay? Top view mode, edit mode, wireframe mode, and I'm just going to extrude it with E all the way across to the other side so it's sticking out. And there you go. Now you've got your shape sticking out both sides. And let's just go ahead and cut that shape out. So select your cube, add modifier, Boolean, select difference, and select our shape, which is the curve this time. And apply, select our curve, and delete it. And there you go. You got that nice little shape cut out of your cube, and that's that. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. Have a good day.